Okay, we ready when you all are. I'll start this one off. Well, hold up. My technique. You ready? Okay, we can roll it.
Greetings, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. We are so happy this Lord's Day to be able to come into your homes, into your places of where you are, to celebrate this Lord's Sunday, as in a Christian faith we call Easter. Sunday celebrating the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. I want to thank Sister Sandy Span for giving us an inspirational ministry of music, reminding us that yes, he rose. For we know that our God is not dead, he is still living in our souls. The word of comfort and encouragement for this Lord's Day is coming from the second chapter of the Gospel of St. John, and the sermonic spotlight will be on verse number 19. You'll find the following words. It says, Jesus answered them, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. Jesus answered them, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. Want to encourage your heart today for this subject, from a victim to a victor. From a victim to a victor. We solicit your prayers, please. Brothers and sisters, this Lord's Sunday, as I mentioned earlier, represents one of the most sacred seasons of our Christian faith. As baptized believers and dedicated disciples and faithful followers of the Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, we are not currently in this nation under human orders to practice social distance and staying at home, not being able to come to the house of the Lord and worship the Lord as a congregation of believers in spirit and in truth. But this text in John's versions of the glorious gospel is tailored to teach us and encourage our hearts today that even in these dark, difficult days, painful, problematic, perilous times, and in this so-called hopeless and helpless hour that we live, the call is still out for the consecrated, converted church of the Lord Jesus Christ to still claim the victory over the enemy. Victory, brothers and sisters, mean that we have been delivered from the agony of defeat. Victory means we are blessed in spite of carrying heavy burdens. Victory means what looks like a mess is really God in the midst working out his miracle. And everything that Satan has planted in your life to use against you, God has already backed things up, flipped the script, and he's working it out for your good. So as bold, blessed believers in the Lord Jesus Christ, we are commissioned to carry our cross. But the church has already been chosen that as we carry the cross, the Lord has a crown with your name on it. And this text is tailored to teach us in John's version as we navigate through this chaos, confusion, social unrest, and uncertainty. The hymnologist reminds us from day to day as we're wondering where do we go from here and how long will this last, but the word of God is there to remind us if there's no cross, then there is no crown. Jesus emphatically tells us in Matthew 16 that if any man, woman, boy, or girl decides to become my disciple, they must first of all deny themselves, take up your cross, then come. follow me. What that means, brothers and sisters, is being a Christian does not mean that you'll always have good days, but you're gonna have some bad days. It means that there will be days where sometimes you're up, sometimes down, and then sometimes level to the ground. Being a Christian means that yes, you are blessed by the best, but sometimes you will feel broken. In other words, yes, as Christ said, destroy this temple, but in 3 days I will rise again. The bottom line is, as Christian believers, we got to realize that this is part of building our faith, that the bad comes along with the good. Oh yes, the hurt comes along with the healing. And so therefore, as we navigate and as we walk by faith and not by sight, the songwriter reminds us that if you can't stand a little disappointment sometimes, if you can't stand being talked about sometimes, if you think life is about always being up and never being down, I came to remind you, if there's no cross, then there is no crown. In other words, Jesus reminded us that he can relate to all of our hurt. He can relate to all our pain. He can relate to all our sicknesses. He can relate to all our sadness and sorrow. In other words, Jesus said, yes, I was a victim, but he said, I transformed into a victor. In other words, he gives us a revelation in the midst of his situation that as being a victim who became a victor, we have to always relate to our own lives. And can anyone say today, as a blessed believer and a willing witness and a redeemed of the Lord, for the psalmist said, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. So can anyone lift their voice and say that yes, in the midst of victimization all around us, but I still hold on and hold fast to the faith, knowing that victory is mine. Oh yes, yes, it's hard. For now we have to stay at home. Yes, it's hard when we practice precautionary procedures. Yes, it's hard because we're trying our best to stick to social distances as our healthcare is crying out for help in healing. Jobs are temporarily being terminated and our faith is constantly on the fire and people are trying to hold on and hang on in there. But Jesus let us know that yes, though he destroyed this temple, in 3 days I will rise again. In other words, trouble don't last always, but there's a better and brighter day ahead. We got to be reminded, saints, if Jesus was betrayed, the question is, then what about me? If Jesus was denied, then what about me? If Jesus was lied on and persecuted, then what about me? If Jesus was whipped all night long, had to carry a red cross to a hill called Calvary, nails in his hands and his feet. Oh yes, do you realize that the biggest mistake that the Roman soldiers made is that when they nailed him to the cross, they turned around and lifted him up. Oh, y'all remember what the word says in John 12 and 32. Jesus said, if I be lifted up above the earth, I'll draw all men unto me. Yes, they lifted him up. Yes, they had destroyed him and brought him down, but they turned around and lifted him up. And as he hung on that cross, lifted up, they tell me that they pierced him in the side, and out came blood and water. But then the hemologist picked that up and came up with a song that says there is a fountain that's filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's into the hands of his Father. Jesus uttered one last word by saying, "It is finished." Notice he said, "It is finished." Not "I am finished." He said, "It is finished." The redemptive work of salvation has been completed. It is finished. For now the poor has received the good news of the gospel. It is finished. For the captives have been set free. It is finished. For the blind has received sight. The lame can now walk. The dumb can now talk. And those whom life has knocked you down, now you can get right back up, claiming all power and victory through your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, he said, "It is finished." But he said, "I am not finished." Because when they lifted him up, the hurting got the healing of the nation. The sinners got salvation in their souls. They lifted our Savior up. So all the same, brothers and sisters, in times like these, remember that we are serving a lifted Savior who has all power in his hand. But can anyone ever relate? Can we testify in these perilous times that we live, that though we've been knocked down, we can get back up? For when Jesus got knocked down on that Friday, they tell me that early Sunday morning, about the break of day, that an angel came from heaven and rolled the stone away, and God raised him up with all power in his hand. Well, good day, my brothers and sisters. May the Lord bless you real good. But on Easter Sunday morning, I'm claiming the victory. Oh, yes, things may not look good right now, but I'm claiming the victory. That I'm not a victim, but a victor, because this too shall pass. I'm not a victim, but a victor, because if God takes me to it, he's already taken me through it. I'm a victor and not a victim, because I shall reap in due season if I faint not. I'm not a victim, but a victor, because if I hold to God's unchanging hand, he has already fought my battle, and I have already won the war. I am a victor and not a victim, because weeping may endure it for the night, but joy will come in the morning. Yes, I'm so glad I am a victor, because on this Easter Resurrection Sunday, our God is not dead, but he's still alive, because he lives in our souls. So if he lives today, I can face tomorrow, because he lives. All my fear is gone, because he lives. I may not know the age of a rock, but I know the rock of ages, because he lives. I may not know my future holds, but I know the one who holds my future in the palm of his hand. So wherever you may be, just throw your hands in the air, lift up your voice, and give God the glory, give God the praise, give God the thanks, because we are victors and not victims. Yes, we are navigating through, but we are victors, because we have the victory. Jesus has resurrected, and we too shall rise above it all. As we close our prayer, our prayers that God will continue to keep each and every one of you in his care. Let us pray. Gracious God, Heavenly Father, we're so grateful and thankful for this day you've given us. We're thankful for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for giving us another day's journey. Thank you, Lord, in the midst of a time where folk are still waiting upon you. But yet you said, "They that wait on the Lord shall renew the strength You have let us revise. Because you live, we can still live. And let the joy of the Lord be our strength. In Jesus' name we pray. May the people of God say amen. Amen. Amen.